thank you. Okay, so it is one thing for us to tell you that driving on ice is dangerous, but tonight we have a demonstration to show you how long it can take to stop on a sheet of ice. WYFF News 4's Angela Rodriguez takes us on the hockey rink at the Bon Secours Wellness Arena.
It's a first for WYFF News 4. The Greenville Warriors allowed us to drive on the ice. We used four different cameras to show you how long it could take to come to a complete stop on a sheet of ice. Arena General Manager Roger Newton was behind the wheel.
That's real life conditions there.
Going 5 miles per hour, after hitting the brakes, it took 10 feet to stop. We did it again at 10 miles per hour. This time, it took 20 feet to stop moving. And at 15 miles per hour, it took 35 feet. Now to simulate a real life scenario, we added water. And the results were drastically different. This is how it looked at 5 miles per hour.
We tapped the brakes at the blue line.
We got out the measuring tape.
Now, you know, there's very little traction, and it's kind of scary, actually.
And took it up to 10 miles per hour.
Basically, it was three times the stopping distance.
This time, it took nearly 50 feet to stop. As the wheels skidded, seconds felt like minutes. Now, even a machine built for ice, like this, a Zamboni, will still skid when you stop on ice. What we can't recreate with our demonstration are curvy roads and hills. Be careful out there. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF,